waking up to nothing but a pen in the pad. Last night, I was dreaming, had a Benz in the jet. Fantasy is everything when it's something you wanna have. But for now, I'm on the app, but just recording in the lab. To my trouble back in school, he's escorting me out of class. Forever thinking about the future, so I never did pass. I used to tell a lot of jokes, the nerds never did laugh. I just SAT in the bag, like I ain't know how to act. Wasn't writing reports, of course not. I rapped in music class, hell, I made a course. I fuck the shit, I'm out, kiss my ass, I take the talents to the street.
What up, YouTube? This your boy Down Low, back for another good plan. But before then, let's talk about something that's going on in the music industry, man. So Capitol Records is bringing back Priority Records, in which, for those of you who don't remember Priority, that was pretty much the flagship record label for all gangster rap back in the day. Like, they the first ones that put out Eazy-E, N.W.A. and all that shit. But you know, they're trying to use the past highlights and shit to promote this brand coming back out, and I'm like, fuck that. A label is a fucking label. What else you got? But the thing that I really want to talk about here is how they're bringing back out this label, man. And it's interesting. Like, they're trying to be the first mainstream producer-driven record label. Now, some key producers that they're putting out there, man, relatively shortly is going to be Just Blaze and Harry Fraud as producers putting out projects. Now, I like this because it opens up doors for a lot of producers out there. So this is something I'm definitely going to keep my eyes on, man. But anyway, on to today's reply. And today's reply is the future, the way I live. And you know what? This track is fucking garbage. And let me tell you why the song is fucking garbage. And let me tell you why the song is fucking garbage. Because Future can't rap, nor can he fucking sing. But yet, he's gonna throw these damn After Effects, he's gonna throw that damn auto-tune on him. And this is something everyone has to fucking know. If you're gonna put auto-tune on something, the track has to already be hot. Like, if you throw auto-tune or even chop and screw something that's not very good to begin with, you're not gonna save the track. In fact, you're gonna make that song unbearable to fucking listen to. And I know all of the Future fans and shit are gonna pop up saying shit like, he got money though, he's known, why is you hating on him? Yes, he does have a name, and I respect any black man that's getting paper and shit off of that. But having a name and being known in the music industry has nothing to do with your skill level, in which that's what today's article is about, but we gonna talk about that later. You have to spend years to master your lyrics, master your flow, master your singing techniques, man, before you can even put on any of these motherfucking effects. But sadly, too many people think they can just hop in the booth, sing something completely off tune, and auto-tune is gonna fix that shit. You guys are really clowning yourself. But anyway, on to that article, man, in which the article is about talent isn't the thing that's going to put you on in the music industry. See, too many rappers out there, when you ask them, what is it that you do that differentiates yourself from everyone else? They're gonna say some shit like, I'm better than all of these other rappers. What the fuck does that mean? Especially when this industry is based on people's opinion of music. There's nothing set in stone that says you're better than any fucking body. I mean, anybody who really listens to music knows what a good artist sounds like, man. But too many people don't, and these are the people that's buying albums, and these are the people that's getting people put on. See, there are tons of terrible rappers in the music industry, dude. These rappers figured out the fucking truth. It doesn't matter how good you are or how bad you are in this game. What really matters is if you're known, if you're making fucking money, because that's what these A&Rs and record labels are going after. These motherfuckers don't know good music to save their fucking life. The people who run the music industry, man, are pretty much fucking accountants. All they do is look at who's making what money. Let's get that money on our brand. Not who's making good music and see if we can put this music out there and maximize the potential to make the money. It's not how motherfuckers think no more. You definitely want talent so you can have longevity in this game. But yet you can't rely on talent to be the thing that gets your feet in the fucking door. Your promotion has to be right.